Now iCloud, I'm going into my Pages account, my desktop publishing online. I can drag and drop images into documents. I can create from templates, all kind of cool, quick and easy, dirty DTP. I mean, it's, you know. So here's a document, and I want to get this Pages layout into InDesign. You can see with here I can download a copy, in other words, output a copy in various formats, EPUB, Word, PDF, and of course native Pages to use my desktop. This is all online here. But I want InDesign. How can I do that? Well, just choose the PDF. It'll prepare a PDF for you. And once you have that PDF, we can use a special Markzware tool to convert it into an InDesign document with one click. Here's a PDF. I moved on to other machine here. This is the Apple Pages PDF. I did a couple adjustments. I added a shadow with a yellowish tint to it to give it a supermoon flavor. And this mistake, I actually let it in. It appears okay on screen, but when Pages outputs it, it has a different black than the other blacks. What's neat is that in Pages you can get these hyperlinks, and they work right in the PDF or whatever it may be. PDF. Now we're going to go into InDesign CC 2015. We're going to go up top to Markzware menu item PDF2DTP, which we've downloaded after we bought a license for a mere 199 euros or dollars. We click Convert PDF. We can select the PDF. I click Open. Okay. It converts right over. Styles, fonts, images, extracts the images even. And there you go. Look at that. It looks remarkably the same. You even see better here the different black than on the other machine. Could be a screen issue. In any event, you get the entire file as it was in Apple Pages, even with the shadowing and the exact font use. This should be Futura, and indeed it's Futura. And that's the headline A, and it's headline A. It's just so amazing. Saves you so much time, effort, and money. You know, obviously this is just a small test document. If you had a bigger file, a bigger Pages newsletter or document you wanted to convert over, this would just do it for you like that. Now the example I wanted to show you, you see over here you get all of your images, and I can click on this image and I can see it right here. And I said, well, I want to put an image with a richer black background, so I can delete this out and I can add another image. This is now a fully editable InDesign document. It's that simple. You can edit, save, do what you like. And one thing I want to show you, we're going to close this out right now. What you get over here is a document folder from that PDF that's now an InDesign file, and you get all of the images extracted out as used in the document. So you'll get exactly the size used, this background image I had in there. There's one on the moon. So pretty neat stuff. It's all done with Markzware's PDF2DTP. Click on that right there on the Markzware.com site and get more information and see how you can download it right now and get busy with this incredible PDF to InDesign conversion filter. In this case, effectively, an Apple Pages to InDesign converter.